series of crimes in the US linked by many there to right-wing politics are becoming the baseline topic in news coverage stateside. And with just days to go until America's polarized public make their choice in the midterm elections, the rhetoric is getting fiery. One CNN host is clear as to who he thinks poses the real terror threat.
We have to stop demonizing people and realize the biggest terror threat in this country is white men, most of them radicalized right, to the right.
Well, Don Lemon's comments come after three recent hate crimes involving white suspects. Last Saturday, 11 Jewish worshippers were massacred at a synagogue in Pittsburgh. In the same week, two black people were killed in a shooting at a supermarket in Kentucky. And 15 mail bombs were sent to high-profile opponents of the U.S. president. Well, we heard contrasting views from inside the U.S. from journalist Julio Rivera and political activist Anthony Rogers Wright.
I think that Mr. Lemon was actually stating facts. There were twice as many terrorist incidents from white right-wing terrorists than those of people who submit to al-Islam.
What they're saying right now is saying that the majority of the country are terrorists. I'm pretty sure that if white men were the real problem in America, we'd have a higher rate of incidents with these types of terror attacks.
Radicalized white people who are sending pipe bombs to people of the opposing party, who just killed 11 Jewish people, who just killed two black people in Kentucky because they couldn't get into a black church. Look at the resulting deaths and look at the perpetrators.
CNN is doing everything they can to try to cast a negative light against anything Trump, and obviously the majority of the voting bloc in America is working class white men. These incidents that are being painted are happening right now are being painted as Donald Trump's fault when it's really not true. People like Don Lemon are going to continue to perpetuate these false narratives in the hopes that maybe it can distract people from what's actually going on in America, which is a great thing right now economically. Numbers for people across all demographics, including white, Latinos, and blacks in particular, where black unemployment is at a historic low.
Pipe bombs that were just sent did not kill anyone, but they were still acts of terrorism. And you can't deny that. The person who was caught by the FBI is a Donald Trump supporter. And if we are being honest,
really, but he is a registered Democrat, though. There's information.
He's a Donald Trump supporter.
We can slice this up a bunch of different ways. You can't sit there and place him and state that he's specifically a Donald Trump supporter if he was inspired to do that by Donald Trump.
We have to be honest about post-Reconstruction white terrorism against black people. If we're not being honest about that, we're not going to get to the root of the problem. White supremacy founded the United States of America. White supremacy exists in the United States of America. And white supremacy is rising across the world.
What Don Lemon said, this is just a furtherance and a continuance of the division that was created in America under the 8-year administration of Barack Obama.